Okay, now we are going to learn about software product lines. So this, what is this software product lines? Why are we using this software product lines? Okay, what is the necessity need in a real time market like that? We are going to learn now. So first of all, software product line. Why are we going for this software product line in the sense? Okay, a software architecture represents a significant investment of time and effort, usually by a senior talent. Okay, whenever we are developing some software architectures, those architectures may take lot of time to develop, as well as lot of effort to complete that architecture, and also with some special talents, isn't it? While developing one software product, so that software product need time. It may take not only 10 days, it may take 100 days or 1 year or 2 years also. Some products may need for developing of that projects, it will take long times. So, and also it's a effort of not only single person, it's a group of people effort. And also usually, and in the while developing that project, we are including in that project some senior experts, based on their their suggestions itself, we are working on that, isn't it? So development of one software architecture, it may need time, effort, and some talents. So if we want to maximize the return investment on that, what should we do? We are taking 1 year time or 2 year time, 2 years time to develop one project. So that project should be applicable for only small purposes, means it's not a that much satisfaction thing, isn't it? Our effort, 2 years effort, 1 year effort may use by only few people, may understand by only few people, and it's not give that much of outcome, benefit to the developers as well as to the customer like that. There is no that much of satisfaction on that. If you will develop that one project, we think that project will be used by anyone in the world, anywhere in the world. So like that, we have planned and implemented one such particular projects. Clear? If you are working on something, that may be useful for many people, many areas, and also we are expecting our product will be marketed throughout the world like that. So because of that only, we are working on that particular projects, and we sit hours together and to complete that particular project. So clear? So if whatever the developer project is not meet such kind of goals, after developing one project, it's not meet that much of it's only suitable for small projects, and it is used by only less number of people in real time. So like that, it happens. So automatically, whoever the developers of that project may dissatisfied on that particular project. So to overcome this, which means to come out of from this, what we should do. So that, because of that, we are going to implement that project, some modules or some functions of that project or some designs of that project, we are developing those for reusable purpose. Okay, if we will develop one project, okay, not only the overall project, so few functions of that project or otherwise, okay, few components, some modules or something designs, whatever we have included into that particular architecture, those will be reused for some other architectures or for some other structures. Then we may get satisfaction. For example, we thought whatever we have developed, okay, so that should become one of the prototype. That should become one of the prototype. What is a prototype? That is a first version of something. First version of a car, first version of a bike, or otherwise first version of a phone. Okay, it may be something that is a new concept. That is a new thing. Okay, if we developed a new concept or new thing, so automatically many members will ask us a prototype. So by using that prototype, they will develop similar gadgets or similar things related to that. So that is called reusing of our developed product. So when it will be reused by some other people, okay, it is, first of all, it is suitable to everyone, every product, at least it will support some products, and as well as, okay, it is a little bit new one. If it is already existing one, they won't ask us a prototype. They'll go for some other place and they'll take from there and they'll develop their product. If it is new, then they'll come to us and they'll ask from us and they'll take the permission, or we'll grant them to the license. So what is a license here? If we want to use their works or their products or something, we need to take some permission from that organization. Then only we can use their products or something. Otherwise, okay, we can't use such kind of things. So like that, here also, one product is a new one, then we have built one prototype. If whenever we'll build a prototype and many members asked for our design, asked for our architecture or something, new features, whatever we have included in that particular project, okay, they are asking for that new features, new concepts. Okay, so in real time, we are purchasing some gadgets, small coding kits. What is it? Raspberry Pi. Have you heard this word? Raspberry Pi itself. So in that, we have some coding, Java coding. So by using that coding, we are going to develop new things. So that is a basic one. So if you want to develop any programs on Java, okay, for some projects it will support a lot. Already existing things, whatever there into that Raspberry Pi, you can directly, okay, take them and use within your code when developing a project, isn't it? So like this. So why? Because that is one kind of coding that is reusable by any member. If our coding is reusable or shared between multiple architectures or multiple systems, then, okay, that is the asset. of that coding or of that project, of that architecture. Okay, then we are returning, we are getting the amount whatever we spend on that particular architecture, we will get more amount. Okay, that is called returning investment. Return on investment. Whatever we invested something on that particular architecture, so we will get return back if that is used by many people, isn't it? So that's why, okay, we are learning this concept now. What is this concept? This concept is software product line. Software product lines in the sense, if you see the definition of software product line, it is a set of software intensive systems. It is a set of software intensive systems sharing a common managed set of features that satisfies the specific needs of a particular market segment or mission, and that are developed from a common set of core assets in a prescribed way. So these are the sharing of common features in between multiple architectures or multiple projects. So those products will be developed for different purposes, but few things, few coding concepts or few designs are matched to each and every product. Okay, those are matched to each and every product. Like, for example, if somebody is making some batteries, okay, so that batteries are suitable to every gadget. It may suitable to remote control, or it may suitable to toys, whatever we have, and those are suitable to some clock. So somewhere else, so such kind of batteries, once if you develop battery, but that is not overall gadget. But gadget, it is different. One gadget is different from other gadget. But in all gadgets, but in all toys, here we are going to use some batteries. And there is a difference between one clock to another clock. Models, designs and companies, so many differences are there. But in that also, we are using some batteries. Like that, even remotes also. So remotes are also different for company to company, and TV to TV, those are different company remotes will be available in market. But in that, if you want to operate those remotes, we should use some batteries. What it is here, it is a batteries is a one of a product which is used by many different gadgets. Here also, we are developing coding or some designs for some particular project. Those designs, okay, or those requirements, those designs, or those coding, or those testing things, whatever we have used into that particular project, those things may be suitable for some other projects. Okay, so whatever the testing tools we have used into our project, that may be suited to some other project. Okay, whatever the design techniques we have implemented in our project, that may be suited to project two. Like that, not all the things, okay, at a time, but maybe few things in that particular project may be used by individual projects itself. So here the software product line is also it's a set of software intensive systems. So these are shared a common managed set of features that satisfies the specific needs of a particular market segment or mission. Okay, so which means reusing of the okay software, reusing of the software. Software may be we are learning this software in two kinds. First one, it is a coding or it is a complete product. Okay, software in the sense, in our general coding, whenever we are learning some coding subject, software is called a set of instructions or set of programs. Like that, we have learned one definition for software, isn't it? So software in the sense, it's a set of instructions to develop a program or to develop a task. And second definition of, second form of a software is, it's a complete product or project. Clear? So that it is. So yeah, now we are learning this software product line. Software product line in the sense, if you developed one software, okay, that software, into that software we have many phases. Okay, in that software we have many phases. Any phase of that software may be reused by some other systems. So this reused concept is one of the asset, one of the asset to a every project, or that is a big asset to the, I mean, a prototype, whoever developed that one, for the, for that people, that is a big asset. Is it? Okay, software product lines, that's why here software product lines is also called as reusing architectural assets. Reusing architectural assets. Clear? This is about software product lines. Software product line means gathering of in real market, in real market, if we'll talk about what is this product line means, so there they'll sell some gadgets, some gadgets, it's there they'll put a collection of some gadgets or gadgets or something related to a software, and they are ready to sell those things. So whoever have needs of that particular Raspberry Pi, like that, we are having a different, not only one, many are available in market. So that is a place, the product, software product line is a place to sell the, okay, codes for reusability purpose. It's not maybe code, it may be a design, it may be a testing tool, whatever it may be. Okay, it's a software. It's a software. So it is a like selling place. Selling place is called software product line. Clear? Now we are moving to the okay, wait a moment. Now we are moving to the next slide, that is what makes software product lines work. What makes software product lines work? So first of all, requirements gathering and architectural design. So whatever the requirements gathered for designing something or designing, I mean, develop a project, then that requirements also, okay, that requirements also, so used as a software product line. Okay, those will support the reusability of that, the reusability things of that particular software. Coming to the second one is architectural design. So whatever the design we have used into our project, so that design also a one of the reusable one. So that is a newly founded design. So that is shared by many members. By following that design only, all are get ready to design that one. Okay, if we started doing one painting by using something, by using sand we can make one paint, or by using pen or pencil, or otherwise some colors. So everything there is a everything we will get one paint, isn't it? So these are multiple things are available to do a paint, isn't it? By using sand, by using or otherwise floor, by using some pencil or some color pencils or some painting things, bottles, whatever we have. So like that we are using for painting, we have many ways to paint that thing. So by using real colors, by using real flowers also will go for a painting. And by using some vegetables also, we will vegetable juice also will use juices for painting itself. So here we have many ways. So like that here also, if you want to develop a design for a project, we are not following one design technique. We are not following one approach. There are many approaches are there in market. There are many approaches are available in market. If that is a new approach, means all are ready to use that one. If it is a new design concept means, and maybe the design is suitable for every front page, everybody's front page. Okay, they will use that one while designing some user interfaces. So that if designing of one user interface, we are using the same design technique. Okay, same design. Not only for front interfaces. If you want to give some connections between client and server, so the design may be it is a good design. If anybody can use that design, okay, they'll they'll give the connections between client and server easily. So automatically all will follow our designing technique. Okay, so that is the second one. Coming to third one, elements. What is the third one? Third one is elements. Elements in the sense modules. Modules of a project. So one module may suit it to other project itself. Some modules, whatever we have developed. So those modules are suited for our project, some other projects. So like that. After that, modeling and analysis. Modeling and analysis also may be suited to you. And in the testing, so what are the testing testing tools we have used to test, and how we are testing that one. So different types of testings are there in market. So those testing tools are suitable to test any kind of project or not. Okay, so like that, here we are going to learn about testing itself. Next, project planning and processes, methods and tools. Okay, all are supported to reusing of that architectures. And also sometimes people also, if one person designed something, so all are learned that same thing, isn't it? If anything new is coming in market, I'll release in YouTube, so automatically, so whoever interested to do work on that particular model, all are will using that same concept. Otherwise, they are asked to come and show me how to use this one, and please show that one into my organization also. Like that, they'll ask the people. So people are also moving from one place to another place. Okay, so if one person is moving from one place to another place, so that same thing whatever he developed in first place, so he may develop that same thing in second place too. Okay, Nowadays, we are asking APSSDC people to conduct classes or projects like that. So why are we asking that of them? Okay, they are providing some they are providing some courses free for each and every college. Every college, okay, to enlighten the students, okay, to improve the skills of a students in real life. So for that sake, so they'll take initiation to teach the students in different colleges. So they are having some plannings and they are having some schedules to teach on that particular concepts or particular subjects, isn't it? So after one schedule, they'll move to second college, third college, like that. Okay, sometimes are requesting on the management or some people, they'll choose the colleges, which college is the first, which college is the second, like that. So they'll teach their practical knowledge. They may be they are recruiting from a practical environment itself. Okay, they are the working people in some other organization. They are called them and asked them to teach the students. Why? Because from them only students gain more and more knowledge, isn't it? So giving more technical support to the students, they are asking, we are requesting their persons to come to our college and take the classes for my students to like that. So that is also one of the reusability of that people, isn't it? And exemplar systems. So after the deployment stage, after the deployment stage, if we'll take feedback from your customers, they'll give the good feedback, or otherwise after seeing the first project, they'll ask to develop second project itself. After the development phase, deployment phase, after the completion of code development, they may be asked for new project with the same team members. So they're requesting for the same team members. So they may be use the same things for a second project too, almost whichever is needed for that project, they'll take or they'll inherit the properties of this project. Clear? And also defects, whatever the defects, last point is defect eliminations. Whatever the defects in project one, they may avoid that one and they'll take only the remaining concepts to develop another software. So this is the points. These will make a product lines and reusability of that particular software architectures. Coming to the next slide. In this next slide, what is the scoping? The scope of a product line defines what systems are in it and what systems are out. Okay, if we have created one new thing, if it is a reusable one, so everybody asked for that and used for that, and at least they'll ask some features of that particular project. If some products are not suited for reusability things, means they'll come into the market and they'll fade up from market itself. When they'll come, we don't know. When they fade off from the market also, we don't know. Okay, such kinds of systems also there in market. If one design is available for new design is came into the market. Okay, so the design is supported for everything. that phone design is supported for everything means we will use that one, which means that phone, if any phone problem is that phone is getting any problem means we need some service centers. If the charger will okay, if you want to buy new charger for that phone means the chargers also suited to that phone itself, and many things we are checking if we want to buy one phone. So that phone, if that phone is get repaired, okay, nearby to our house or nearby to our area, there is a service centers to this phone or not, we are checking for that one. Okay, is it support whatever the requirements I have or not, we are checking for that too. And if suppose the chargers or some earphones are okay, some if you want to buy new charger and new earphones for that phone, is it suitable any charger or not? So like that we are checking some work basic things. If that phone is like that, then we are ready to purchase that phone if it is a new design. But it's not supporting such kind of things whatever we are expecting, then we are avoiding. Why we are taking chance? If somebody is telling no, there is no service center here, if you will buy this phone, it will get any problem, if you will go to the Hyderabad or some Bangalore or some foreign, you should go there and get repair this one, like that they'll say to us means we won't purchase such kind of phones, isn't it? If any problem will occur with that gadget, that will be addressed immediately nearby to our houses itself, or at least our location itself, then we are ready to purchase that things. Otherwise, we are not touch that things. So this is also okay. The scoping in the sense, it is also same thing. Some products, okay, may be suitable to okay any human being. I mean thoughts or any human being attitudes. So he'll buy that gadget or buy that product. But something it's not suitable to their thinking attitudes, then they'll release into the market and fade off from the market itself immediately. And next point, defining a product line scope is like drawing a dot net in the space of all possible systems. Okay, whenever we are going to define one product line, we are announcing that, if we are announcing that we are designing something new, so in that new also developed based on some standards, some universal standards. If you will develop new thing, it's okay. But the supporting things of that new gadgets should be the universal components. Then all are ready to purchase your product. Okay. And coming to the next one. So architectures for product lines. The software architecture plays the most central role. The software architecture plays most central roles for a product line. Whatever the architecture we have developed for a software, that architecture plays important role for a product lines. Why? Because product lines, it's a combination of the features of architectures itself. Now we are going to reuse something. What we are reusing, it's a or one piece of architecture. It's a one piece, one part of a architecture. It may be a design, it may be a code, or it may be a testing tool, or it may be a some required thing. So it's a part or it's a piece. okay, by using that only, okay, we are going for reusable thing, or we are going for develop some other projects, isn't it? So that's why the architecture is a architecture plays a okay major center role in product line. And there are a product line architect needs to consider three things: identifying variation points, the second one supporting variation points, and third one evaluating the architecture for product line suitability. So while developing, while one architecture should think, so who is the architect here? Architect is a designer who designed that architecture or that project. Before going to the implementation unit, first of all, there is a design. We need a design or architecture for overall project. So that is developed by an architect. So the whenever our product, okay, should be in a product line, then that should consider the three things. First one is identifying variation points. So what are the things is changed from our software to other softwares. Better to identify those things. Okay, in our project, whatever we have developed, okay, so that is it suitable to everything or only for our product? Is this design is suitable to our product or not? If the same design is used to some other product, how much it will be supported? How much it will be deviated? What is the supporting percentage? What is the deviation percentage? Like this, we should identify some of the designs or some of the functions of that particular project. And if there is a things are ready to support other gadgets also, then we are concentrating on that particular designs or developing things. Okay, if we'll put this design is support to our project, first of all means we'll use that one. And if by using a small modifications on that design, that will be supported to any gadget or any software, means okay, we are included that particular thing itself. If we are designing one code, okay, we are writing one program for some purpose, okay, by adding two or three more lines into that coding, then it will give some other output also. Like that, if we have an idea, then automatically we will write that two, three code lines into our program itself. What is the need to go for some other program, writing of complete program? It's some waste of time, isn't it? If we have developed one code with 100 lines, that will give one kind of output that may be suitable to you. If that code, okay, by adding two or three lines to that particular code, then it will give some other output which is liked by, okay, some other person, then better we will put that two lines into that code itself. Okay, whenever we are need that two lines, we are automatically include those two lines. Otherwise, just we'll avoid those two lines and we'll execute the remaining thing. Isn't it? So each and every program language has some library functions. What are the library functions? By using that functions, we can execute our programs in a smooth manner, or it will give some kind of outputs with less lines of code. By using some library functions, we can execute our programs with less number of codes, isn't it? With less number of lines of codes. Whenever we are using those things, then we are okay, asking include so and so some native functions. In Java, we'll call it as native functions. In C or C++, we call it as library functions. For that, we are going to write hash include std.h like that. So those are the inbuilt predefined library functions. So here also, we are while designing something, some predefined things also included in that. If that project needs or support that predefined things, then they'll use that one. And no need of go for some other kind of development or architecture or some other kind of implementation. Same our code they'll use for their purpose, isn't it? So that if that particular code or particular module is supported to some other project itself, we should encourage that one. We should encourage that one while developing that one towards to. It is useful to every project like that. We should concentrate on that and we should develop that one. Last one, evaluating the architecture for the product line suitability. So after after architecture is finished, then also again we will evaluate that project. Not only some other parts of this project is suitable to product line or not, which means we may reuse that codes or we may reuse that things or not. So for that one, we have performed some evaluation on that particular project. Clear? And this is about scoping. And coming to the last one, last slide in this topic, what makes a software product lines difficult? So some difficulties is also there. So what are those? Coming to the first one, it may be a developing organization. Okay, it takes a certain maturity in the developing organization to successfully fill a product line. So the developing organization may support or may not be support to do such kind of things. They have their barriers. Okay, if that particular code is suited to some many products, but need some more budget or some more time to develop. Okay, but for such case, in such cases, the organization people may not support. So that is one of the problem, difficult. Okay, sometimes we are going to purchase some items with less cost. Why? Because so same product is available with high cost and also low cost. Some cases, if that usability of that one is less, then we are going for a low cost product itself than high cost product, isn't it? If we'll use that one time or two time, then we'll purchase a low cost one. If I want to purchase a book, if I want to purchase a notebook, okay. So that notebook is, if I want to keep that notebook, for many years, then I'll take costly book, quality book, isn't it? But if that notebook is used for me only for one day or 2 days or for unnecessary purpose, means I'll purchase only less cost book itself, isn't it? So even though the person is saying that it's not that much qualitative one, which means it's not good to you, better to take a good notebook like that, the selling person is suggested to me, then also I'm not interested to listen his words. My thinking, my thought, I'll go according to my attitude, my thinking. So I'll go with low cost book itself. So like that. Okay. That may be useful for future itself. Okay. may be used or may not be used, that is secondary. But at that time, at that situation, I'll go and choose that one. Here also, if one product is okay, is it reusable one means it may need more time to develop, or more what expert persons to develop, or otherwise more cost, I mean more budget. So if because of these factors they are not allowed to get ready this product lines, isn't it? And coming to the next one, yeah, same. Technology is not the only barrier to this. Organization, process and business issues are equally vital to master to fully reap the benefits of the software product line approach. So organization or process or some business issues, they, because of many issues, okay, the product is not in a product line or it's not in a reusable state. Coming to third one, the Software Engineering Institute has identified 29 issues or practice areas that affect an organization's success in filling a software product line. Okay, there are different issues are there in software engineering institution to develop something. So if you are ready to face all of those, then you can develop your project. Otherwise, we'll come back that one. Okay. Most of these practice areas are applied during single system development, okay, as well, but take on a new dimension in a product line. Better whenever we will develop this one, if it is a okay single system development, which means it is used for only small kind of projects. If one thing we have developed that is only supported few users or few customers thing, so on that places we are going to go for this trial version of a product line, okay. But if it is a big project, big kind of things are involved in that, okay, there is no chance to take this product line issues or reusing of that code. So this is about software product line. Software product line in the sense, it's completely about reusability of a software. One software is suitable to one software is suitable to other software or not. If it is suitable, then that is a good initiative one, and that is a asset to a project, and also it will get a returning that investment whatever we have put on that particular project. Okay, this is about today's class. Thank you.